The Labvanced Experimental Task Wizard offers a new way to experimental design, helping you create tasks faster than ever before. Just by making a few selections and using a CSV file or spreadsheet, you can set up an experimental task in a few minutes. The Task Wizard addresses many crucial aspects of experiment creation for you, such as stimuli presentation, trial setup, events for data recordings and experiment progression, eye and mouse tracking setup, randomization, and more. In short, it is a fast and intuitive way to create custom experiments, and over 90% of experiments can be created with this approach. To explain how the Experimental Task Wizard works and how to use it, you first need to understand how experimental tasks work within the Labvanced framework and how that's related to structuring your CSV file or spreadsheet. That is because the CSV file is the main data source that the Task Wizard uses when setting up the experimental tasks for you. In Labvanced, experimental tasks are tasks that consist of multiple trials or repetitions. In each of these trials, the same type of stimuli are presented. However, the identity or content of the exact stimulus typically changes between trials. For example, an experimental task could consist of two pictures shown side by side and a text stimulus shown underneath. The entire task might consist of 40 trials, but in each of these trials, the participant is shown two different pictures and a different text. Instead of images and text, you can of course also use videos or auditory stimuli. And after the Task Wizard setup is complete, you can also add many other elements to a frame, such as buttons, ratings, input fields, and so on. The most important step in using the Task Wizard is to create the CSV file in the following way. Each stimulus element should have its own column in the spreadsheet. So if you want to present two images and one text stimulus, you need three stimulus columns. If you only have two text stimuli, then you will have two columns for stimuli. Or, if you have a text, an image, and an audio stimulus, then you'll need three columns again. For each trial or repetition of the task, you need to create a new row and write the values for each stimulus element in the cells. The number of rows naturally corresponds to the number of trials per subject in this task. Note that for images, audio, and video stimuli, the file extension, such as .jpg, must be specified, while text stimuli are simply to be entered as plain text. In addition to the stimuli, two other things can be entered in the CSV file. The first is factor or condition information. In Labvanced, factors are categorical descriptors of your stimuli. For example, you might want to differentiate between respondents' answers for two types of image classes, such as houses and faces. Therefore, you can include a column labeled image category in your CSV file, and for each row there are only two possible values, house or a face. The factor value for each row is associated with the stimuli in that row, and it is automatically recorded, making it easier to analyze the data by factor level later on. In advanced designs, you can also have multiple factors, in which case each factor must have its own column. Note that these factors will be crossed and make up your condition space. Also, you can add more factors later in the editor for balancing and randomization. Finally, you can also enter stimulus information in the spreadsheet. This is information that relates to a stimulus, but is not a stimulus itself. It is not shown or presented. For example, you want to find out if the participant has chosen the correct stimulus from two possible options. A column of stimulus information can be used to enter such information about which is the correct stimulus so that you can then compare it with the respondent's choice to calculate whether the answer is correct or not. If you are still unsure how to create your CSV or spreadsheet file for your task, you can also download and view our sample files. After uploading your CSV file and actual stimuli and assigning which columns in the CSV are to be used as stimuli, factors, or information, a few more selections are required to complete the Task Wizard. These include options for pairing stimuli for randomization, placing stimuli on frames in order to control their presentation, and finally determining how to transition from one frame to the next. If you would like to have even more information, please read our text documentation or contact our live chat support. Thank you.